Do you think humanity will make it past 2040, or are we headed for trouble? We're living in a time of unprecedented global challenges. Climate change is accelerating at an alarming rate, with rising temperatures, devastating natural disasters, and unpredictable weather patterns threatening our very existence. Political instability is on the rise, with tensions between nations escalating to potentially catastrophic heights. And amidst all this chaos, technological advancements are happening at breakneck speed, changing the fabric of our societies and economies. In the face of these challenges, it's hard not to wonder if humanity is headed for a cliff. Will we be able to adapt and overcome, or will we succumb to the pressures building around us? The truth is, the future is uncertain, and the path we're on is fraught with danger. A study from the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, known as Limits to Growth, was published in 1972 by a team of researchers at MIT. They used a system dynamics model to predict the consequences of exponential economic and population growth within a finite planet. The researchers forecasted that if society continued on its business-as-usual path, we would face severe resource depletion, environmental degradation, and economic collapse around the mid-21st century, specifically around 2040. The study suggested that the world's population, industrial output, food production, and natural resources would peak and then sharply decline. In 2020, Gaia Harrington, a sustainability researcher, revisited the limits to growth model and says,
"Growth can no longer be humanity's ultimate goal. For this century, we need a more ambitious and mature aim to provide enough for each in a way that can last. My analysis indicates that without significant changes in global priorities and investments in sustainable technologies, we are on track for a potential collapse by 2040.
According to one notable critic of the Limits to Growth study, William Nordhaus, a Nobel laureate in economics,
"The MIT research team that produced The Limits to Growth focused on five basic factors that they claimed determined, and therefore ultimately limited, growth on Earth population, agricultural production, natural resources, industrial production, and pollution. They hypothesized that a growing economy eventually devours its finite supplies of natural resources. I believe that the models used in the study are overly simplistic and fail to account for human ingenuity and technological advancements that can address resource constraints. And that while the report raised important issues, I believe that it underestimated the capacity of economies to adapt and innovate."
Cristiana Figueres, former executive secretary of the UN Framework Convention on Climate Change, on resource depletion and sustainability.
"The budget is the amount of carbon dioxide emissions that can be released into the atmosphere while we still have a chance to limit global warming to the specific goals set by the Paris Agreement. We have already used more than half of that budget. This means that three quarters of the fossil fuel reserves need to stay in the ground, and the fossil fuels we do use must be utilized sparingly and responsibly. It is critical that the world captures every last bit of energy efficiency if we are to reduce greenhouse gas emissions enough to keep below dangerous rises in temperature. I'm pleased that this important new study shows how information and communication technology can play an essential role in saving energy. Now we need more and effective government policies that reward such action and penalize delayed responses."
Quite obviously, if current trends continue, the consequences will be dire. Rising sea levels will displace millions, devastating storms will decimate entire cities, and droughts will plunge nations into famine and chaos. The divide between the haves and have-nots will grow ever wider, sparking social unrest and even conflict. And as resources dwindle, the very fabric of our societies will begin to unravel. But that's not all. The rapid advance of technology could bring about its own set of existential risks. Artificial intelligence could surpass human intelligence, becoming an uncontrollable force that threatens our very survival. Biotechnology could create new forms of life that we can't fully understand or contain, and cyber attacks could cripple our critical infrastructure, plunging us into a digital dark age. The experts are sounding the alarm bells, warning us that time is running out. Dr. David Suzuki, a renowned environmentalist, claims that humanity has only a decade to take drastic action to prevent climate catastrophe. Elon Musk warns that AI could become a greater threat to humanity than nuclear war, and the World Health Organization is ringing the alarm about the looming threat of pandemics in a rapidly globalizing world. The list of potential threats goes on, and it's easy to feel like we're staring into the abyss. But what if we told you that there's another side to the story? That there are people, organizations, and governments working tirelessly to prevent these catastrophes and create a better future? Now we're going to explore the possibilities of a world where humanity comes together to address the challenges facing us, where technological advancements are harnessed to create a sustainable, equitable, and just society. And where the clock is turned back on the doomsday scenarios that threaten our very existence. The turning point could come from anywhere. A breakthrough in renewable energy, a global agreement to reduce emissions, or a technological innovation that makes us rethink our entire approach to the environment. It could be a grassroots movement that spreads like wildfire, inspiring people to take action and demand change from their leaders. Whatever the catalyst, one thing is clear: the future is not set in stone. The decisions we make today, the actions we take tomorrow, and the choices we face in the years to come will all have a profound impact on the world of 2040 and beyond. So, what does the future hold? Will humanity rise to the challenge and create a brighter, more sustainable world? Or will we succumb to the pressures building around us and stumble into a dystopian nightmare? The answer lies in our collective hands. The clock is ticking, and the decisions we make today will shape the course of human history. So what will it be? Will we choose a future of survival or one of sustainability? The choice is ours.